guys, welcome back to my channel for another video. Today we're working on this page, and this is the first time I've actually ever done this technique, I suppose, in one of these books, so I'm pretty excited to do it again. Well, I've done it on the other book that I was making with this one, you know. Anyway, so what I have here is half a doily that is going to go across the top of the page as a top tuck spot. And this is a picture that came from just an old book. I think it was an old Reader's Digest book, you know, the actual books, the hardback books, with the stories in them, and they had some lovely black and white images in there. So I took this image out. It was running across the bottom of one of the pages, and it continued onto the second page. So I used the other part of this in the other book. So I just cut it to the shape of the solid part of the doily. Okay, so I'm going to stick it down to that. And it looks awesome. Here we go. I like the idea of using things like this that aren't necessarily bought ephemera in shops, or even just printed ephemera. I like using pieces that come out of books and things like that. I guess I'm a junk journaler at heart, but I don't have a lot of authentic vintage ephemera, so I can't use vintage junk to make a junk journal. It would have to be printouts and things like that. But yeah, junk journaler at heart. I do have a junk journal actually started and ready to go, so I must start filling that up soon. I have some bits done in it, but not a whole lot. Okay, so we're going to stick this down. Looks like my cutting abilities are slightly askew, but no matter. We'll make it work. We can cut the top off of it. Very pretty, 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 pretty. I like it. Now, when you're doing something like this, obviously you should be using a cloth to do this, just in case you have glue in your hands. But I was fairly sure I didn't, so we're okay. We're a-okay. Where's my scissors? Just trim the top of this off. And voila. Now, this is that. Oopsie. There's bits everywhere. Boy. Okay, so this is going to glue in here like so. Now, obviously, the doily is wider than the page, so I need to center it on the page and mark where I need to cut it. So I'm going to do my flippy trick. Make sure it's lined up properly at the top first. There we go. I'm just going to flip that over and take it off of the other pages, because that would be the smart thing to do. Grab my pencil. And just mark that. Now I will go inside this line a little bit to keep it out from the edge where the fold is, as per usual. There we go. If you can hear the dog out the back, I don't know if you can or not, but if you do, be assured that she's totally fine. She just likes the sound of her own voice when she's outside. Sounds like she's miserable and in somebody's mauling her, but no. That's just how she rolls. She gives out to the world sometimes around her. There's that one. And this one. This is the one I need to go slightly inside. Okay, beautiful envelope that we did in the last video. Put this over here out of the way altogether. I'll just end up getting damaged if I don't. Right. Okay, so that's pretty good. Now, I'm using this as a tuck spot, so I'm only just going to be gluing the two sides and across the top. Doesn't need a whole lot of glue. Paper to paper, and doily to paper even better. The doily is quite light, so it shouldn't take a whole lot of glue to stick that down. Okay, so that's that part done. Next up is the fun part. Okay, so what I'm actually going to do is I am going to be watercoloring the image with some distress inks. I have a few different, not a whole lot, obviously, I don't have a huge range, but I have enough to do a simple detailed colouring on this. I have some green and blue. This is an aged mahogany, but it comes out quite red. Excuse me, there's black that we won't be using. That's the antique linen one that's dry. And I will probably end up using some brushed corduroy and probably some walnut stain as well. Okay, so first off, I'm going to be putting down some chipped sapphire glue. I'm just putting it straight onto my glass mat and bringing out my water brush and picking some of that up. Now, same as watercolors, build it up in layers. I am not a watercolorist, I never could understand watercolors, and actually I had a breakthrough the other day when I was doing this with regards to layers and things. So here we go, we're going to put in some sky. He appears to be up in a tree, so we can put the sky all the way down in all the open spaces. Not being too fussy about the precision of it, as you wouldn't be with watercolors. It's very loose, very flowing. And very pretty, I think. He's a very pretty bird as well. Now, I will build up the blue. It's quite faint at the moment, but I will build it up. And I'm going to continue on with this, and I'll speed up the camera for you so you don't have to go watch me go through the whole thing. I'll just do this blue first, and I'll show it to you, and then I'll speed up the camera. Shouldn't take me long to do it anyway. I found that when I was doing the other one of these, that it was quite relaxing, actually. As I said, I'd never really gotten the whole watercolour thing before till I started doing it on this piece for the other book. And I now I totally get the whole relaxation of it and the whole flow of it. I was always too worried about the precision of it and how to get the colours right, and the colours weren't dark enough and they were too washy, and now I get it. I get it, people. So okay, so this is the first layer fully covered. And I'm going to go back in a little bit darker, kind of from the top down, and maybe grade it out. So I have used distress inks like watercolours before. In a way, I guess I've used them to colour things. I never thought of it as watercolouring at the time. So when I was doing this on the other one, it was the first time I thought of it as watercolouring, which is, you know, it's a breakthrough. It is a breakthrough for me, and I'm quite happy about it. May not be very good at it, but that'll take time and practice, I suppose, if I want to go down that road. Okay, quite liking that. So, that's what we have so far. Just a little tint of blue in the background. So I'm going to continue on with the rest of it and speed the camera up for you. Okay, so I think that's finished. Yeah, I quite like it. It's not perfect. I'm not obviously an artist or anything, but not in that sense. I'm certainly not a watercolour artist, but I like it. I think it's pretty. So there you go. I'm going to zoom you back out. I hope I didn't make it dizzy with the zooming when I was doing that, because I know I'm going to be speeding that up. I'm just worried it might make you all very seasick or something. Goes out of the way. And maybe zoom in back in a tiny, tiny bit. There we go. That's perfect. Okay. Now, we do have this little one down here. And I actually will do that with the ink gold as well. I was thinking about leaving it, but I have the other three done, so it'd be a bit odd not to do it. So, where's my little bits of tape that I actually used a minute ago? I think I threw them away, did I? I did. I just want to tape that down. It'll save me trying to work around it. So I'm just going to detack my tape a bit. Lesson learned with the envelope. And okay, so tiny drop of water for my ink of gold. Just push over the top of it. And here we go. Yeah, I might actually have to get out some more ink of gold. Trying to be frugal here, people. I hope the light is still good. It does seem to be pretty okay, so I'll keep going for now anyway. I actually end up tending to do most of my recording in the evenings, and because I don't have proper lighting, indoor lighting for the videos, I prefer to do it by daylight, by natural light. So I hope I don't leave it too late for the lighting. I hope the lighting is okay. Yeah. Et voila, that's that one done. I was going to try and use that somewhere else, but I'm just going to clear it up out of the way for now. So that's that. And the next thing is we have papers to slip in here. Is that dry? It is fairly dry, yeah. Excellent. And here I have just a sheet of notepaper that came out of a pretty little notebook. I have smeared some ink gold on it. Something like that. Now when I have it on my desk and I water it, I just dip in the pages. And it gives it that kind of, just a little extra something. So pretty paper and some very thin paper that I got in a handmade notebook from the Philippines, I think it was. I got it as a gift from a friend, and I love the paper. It teed up really well, and I like how it sounds and how it feels. So they can slip in there together, all snuggled up. And back into the book. So there we go. Whoops, come back. Another video done and dusted. Am I getting better with the time, guys? Am I? I still haven't managed to actually set a timer for myself. I keep meaning to. Anyway, we shall see. So here we go. And that, I think that looks really pretty, if I do say so myself. And I do like having, you know, something that I've physically done, some sort of art that I've physically done in the books that I make. It doesn't always happen, but I do like to have it there. Okay, so that's it for this video. I know it was kind of, it was really just one page this time, but because of the watercolouring, it was quite long, I think. So I leave it at that for this one, and I hope to see you for the next one. I hope you enjoyed. Questions, comments or anything, do let me know below. Give us a thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell icon as well, so you'll get notifications so you don't miss any of my videos. Okay, talk soon, guys. Bye.